are we today? Welcome back into the greenhouse. If we haven't met already, I am Sam. I'm your plant collector in Melbourne. While I was having a little bit of play in the greenhouse, I was looking at all my plants and I thought to myself, my God, do I get sucked into variegated plants. I wanted to do another collection video, but instead of doing like a genus collection, I thought to myself, why don't I do a variegated one? Because who doesn't love variegated plants? Today, I'm specifically just going to be talking about the white and yellow variegation. I'm not going to touch on pink, even though I have a lot of pink in this greenhouse. In case you are new to the planting community and you don't necessarily know exactly what variegation is, I got you. Variegation is essentially typically a white, a yellow, a color that comes out in plants that is not green and therefore doesn't have any chlorophyll is actually super duper important in plants. I'm talking about the biological thing that essentially turns light into energy. Chlorophyll is found in all of the green parts of your plant, but not in variegation. I've said it once in one of my videos, and I will say it again. Variegation is not good for your plant. This plant right here, so you can see that it has lots of green, it's looking very, very healthy, and it has spots of white. That, my friends, is variegation. And the thing with variegation is that it is actually a mutation in the plant. From my understanding, there is a few ways that plants can end up with this variegation, and that is either genetically or chemically. The one that I understand in nature is that if the gene in a plant kind of goes haywire, it will produce variegation as a mutation, something that is not good for your plant because it doesn't produce energy. To have variegation is not very advantageous. So, which is one of the reasons why, are they going to get rid of the variegation or is it going to be stable? Another thing that I will say is that variegation can be either induced by genetically, there's a mutation, or it kind of like comes out from a virus or chemically and it causes the plant to have a mutation. So it can be within the plant already or it can be induced. There are several types of variegation in different colors, but there's also the type of variegation that is stable and unstable. So that means that if it is stable, the variegation will come throughout the whole plant, maybe not in some leaves, but it will relatively stay within the genetics of the plant and will continue to produce leaves with variegation. Whereas if it's unstable, we have this, I'll try and show you. We have this natural phenomenon, which everyone hates this word, but reversion, or when your plant reverts and it kind of loses its variegation. So a lot of people end up spending quite a decent amount of money on some variegated plants, but not realizing that it may not actually be stable and the plant may actually lose its variegation. So this is an example here that the variegation has come out in this leaf and has not proceeded any further. That is why I have given it the chop, in hoping that the variegation will come out in its new growth. But I tell you what, I am a sucker for variegation. So that's my little summary of variegation. Let's get on to plants. I have a lot to get through and honestly, I don't know where to start. This one is a huge one. I got ages ago and I seriously have been cutting it up so, so much, but it's still so, so huge. And that is my philodendron white princess. I think there's about four different plants in here. She is seriously huge. And she used to have a lot more white when I first got her, but again, she has slowly, slowly been getting rid of some of the variegation and then it sometimes surprises me. But that's probably one of the nicer leaves just there, or even like that leaf there. If you are a fan of a white princess, I know you'll be a fan of the next one. I've already shown you this one, but Philodendron White Knight. And this one has definitely got to be one of my more favorite variegated plants. Really and truly, is it beautiful. And so the leaves are quite similar in the White Princess, but ultimately the reason why I love this plant so much is because it's just so much rounder and plumpier in the leaves, and the stems look like candy canes because it is red and white, just in contrast with the beautiful leaves. It's seriously one of my most favorite plants. This is actually cutting. I've got the mother plant up in there. It's struggling a little bit. It's like that one there. But we do have a new leaf coming up. This one has been in my care, like the mother plant, for 2 years now, and I finally got in a cutting from it. Another thing with variegated plants is that they grow so slow. Not all of them. If it has more white, the slower it grows. This one really and truly has grown really slow. This beautiful thing has already been up on my YouTube, but regardless, it's still one of my favorite variegated plants because it is from a friend, a dear friend, and it is my Jose Buono. And you can probably tell, so this leaf is probably on the way out, but the variegation used to be white. And this one here, would you just look at that leaf? That one is, I can't even tell if that's green or variegated. Don't know. But that leaf there is definitely variegated, and the newest leaf is also going to be very, very variegated. And I'm pretty sure, don't quote me, but I'm pretty sure that this variegation is stable. Feel free to discuss below. Oh, I really want to show you guys my variegated chain of hearts because it is huge. So this actually hasn't been moved in ages, and my gosh, now that I look at it, it has seriously grown so much. It is taller than me. This is my variegated chain of hearts. It is seriously super duper long. The variegation comes out white, but also a super bright pink. I hope it's being picked up on camera. The pink honestly is so gorgeous. Because it is a succulent plant, this plant really and truly enjoys it a lot better when it is outdoors. When I used to have it indoors in my room, it grew so slowly. But as soon as I put it in direct sunlight, somewhere warm, and it really has flourished. And it's gotten a lot more pink now that it gets some really direct sun. Ooh, this is definitely, oh, I gotta show you this strand. Look how beautifully variegated this string is. Oh gosh. That is super white. Like, it has no green besides this little tiny leaf. All of that is white. So that is the potential that this plant actually has. It's beautifully variegated, white and pink, and the flowers are really cool as well. Beautiful. This is probably my only succulent that I own. I might show this amazing leaf of this Monstera Thai constellation, which technically isn't mine. It's actually my sister's. So this is a cutting that my sister did and technically is for sale. These were the two original leaves. They're quite large. As you can see, it's bigger than my head. Another one there, but look at this newest leaf. So from my understanding, Thai constellations, unlike the Bozigiana, is actually stable in variegation. No matter when you cut it, how you cut it, the duration of how long you have this plant, it will stay variegated. This leaf, because it has so much variegation, will probably die off. Again, something to consider when you have variegated plants. But hopefully, because it has this huge green leaf, it might be able to compensate for this leaf, and hopefully it won't brown. But in my experience, ones that are super duper white end up going brown. If you're looking for some, me and my sister have some on the website. I was thinking I wasn't going to put this plant into the video because I feel like I just show this plant so often, but I may as well because it is, of course, a variegated plant. And it is my Alocasia Frydeck. And I honestly don't know whether this plant is like yellow or white variegated because this old leaf, which is on its way out, the variegation used to be very white. And then this, when it first came out really yellow, and now it's kind of going more into a white color. This plant really and truly is a surprise every time a new leaf comes. I think the newest leaf would be right there. So you can see that it has a lot of green, and I feel like, so it was, this is the second newest leaf, and then this leaf, and I feel like it was just trying to compensate for all of the variegation on this leaf. I don't know if you guys experience this too, but when your Alocasia has like a baby on its way, like, you know, a bulb, the next few leaves will be smaller and then like older leaves will die off. So this happened and I was like, don't tell me there's a bulb. Does that mean my variegated Frydeck is gonna have a baby? It sure is. I don't know if you guys can see it, but we have a bulb right there. See that round thing that kind of looks like a stone?
bulb.
I am so excited because the chances of, like, it's the same plant and it's a bulb from the variegated, mutated, if you will, plant. So hopefully I will also have another pup of this variegated Friday. Seriously, one of my most favorite plants. Last one for the white variegated plants. And you know what's coming up because it hasn't popped up just yet. It is the Monstera Bowsergiana variegata. I always understand why people will love this plant and continue to love this plant, because it seriously is such a statement piece. And once the leaves end up having fenestrations, and yeah, it was definitely one of my very first variegated plants that I was interested in. And I feel like this plant is the most popular variegated plant. I was so lucky enough to get my first cutting of my Bowsergiana in 2018, in June, July, during winter. It was a cutting, it had a long aerial root, 2 nodes and 2 leaves. And the variegation on it was spectacular. And this plant I've multiplied into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I think like 7 or 8 plants now. So it just goes to show, like, after a year or two that you really can multiply and propagate all of your plants. All of these variegated monsteras I will be selling on the shop, but they're just getting ready. I always think, do I like grow it out so that it's an established plant, or do I just sell cuttings? I never know. But I don't know about the variegated Aurora. I think I'll be keeping that one for myself. Since I've already mentioned it very, very briefly, variegated Monstera Aurora Alba Variegata. And for people that are not very aware of what I mean by Alba or Alba, when a plant has Alba Variegata, that means that it is more of the yellow variegation, and Albo, with the O instead of an A, is a white variegation. It's been interesting because I have noticed more yellow variegated monsteras coming up on the market, but the variegation is very different. So instead of it being more like blocky, it looks more like a Thai constellation. It comes out yellow and then fades off from yellow being to more like a creamy color and looks like a Thai. I don't know what that's about, but if you've seen it as well in Australia, what are your thoughts? Now, I have 3 plants left to show you guys. Definitely been one of my tried and trues. I've had this for quite some time, and it is from Haley and Jake, which I received just a small cutting off, and this is my Philodendron Cream Splash. People always think, what's the difference between a Cream Splash and a Brazil? So Brazil normally have just the yellow variegation, but Cream Splash have a tinge of white, looking a little bit more like green and creamy rather than yellow. Something a little bit like that, or oh, this one is fantastic just there. Hopefully you can see that there's a lot of like the cream color coming out through there. But this one I actually have also a lot of cuttings of that are just sitting in one of these classic things. So if you're wondering if Cream Splashes are going to be in a Plant Collector Melbourne store, they definitely are, and they're well and truly on their way. We've got some awesome roots happening in there as well. So one thing I was finding so difficult was trying to propagate Cream Splashes, and I just couldn't figure out why, because when I first and originally got my cutting from Haley and Jake, it rooted so quickly in sphagnum and it was no issue whatsoever. But every time I tried cutting it and propagating it, it would just die. Like, it would just rot, and I didn't have much luck with them until I figured out rooting them in water really truly improved my success rate for any of my philodendron Cream Splash cuttings. I'm putting them in water and then I pop them in sphagnum, and they are well and truly on their way. Another variegated plant, Cream Splash. And the last two here, I have my Philodendron Florida Beauty. So this one here is more of like a yellow variegation. And if you haven't seen the video of me unboxing this, I'll leave the link up above. But this one here, I recently got maybe about 2-3 weeks ago. And typically the Florida Beauty has a lot more variegation from the ones that I've seen. This one has a little bit less, but as you can see, the new leaf has popped out and it's got some great variegation there. I think it's kind of hard because it's, the variegation is a little bit polarized at the moment. So it looks green, but I can tell exactly where the variegation is going to kind of show up as, like here and here. Back of the leaves got a lot of variegation as well. I've never had a Florida Beauty before, but what I hear is that they do end up reverting quite quickly. So this will be quite interesting if the next few leaves end up being more variegated, if I can somehow keep it happy to promote the variegation or even just keep it stable, or if it will actually just decline in time and not have any more variegation. And the last but not least is my Philodendron Brule Marx Fantasy. Oh no, it's not even fantasy, my bad. This is my Brule Marx Variegata. This is one of the most striking yellow plants that you could possibly come across, and it is definitely one of my favorites. It was from a beautiful friend. Seriously, is just so striking. So this guy has really and truly kept a lot of its variegation, as you can see, even this like fully yellow leaf, which will probably die off. But another thing that I hear about these is that they do revert eventually. I've had this discussion with someone, and someone told me that variegation is more genetic. You can't really do anything about it in terms of like encouraging or discouraging it. It's ultimately like determined in the plant. But for me, I don't know what it is, but when I put my variegated plants in more sun, I find that they can keep producing variegated leaves. In my head, it's kind of like compensating. If a plant is not receiving enough light, I find that it pushes out a lot of green leaves to get as much energy for the plant that is possible. But when I put my plants, like this guy, in really bright light, I feel like the green can stay at bay because it's like compensating that this plant gets so much light that even if it has the variegated leaves and it's not photosynthesizing a lot, but because there is a lot of light, can like afford to not have a lot of green, if that makes sense. So it's just a theory of mine. All my variegated plants that are in really bright light tend to be super variegated, and when I put them in a dark spot, they normally come out with more green leaves. But maybe that's just a theory or something that I've experienced. I think that concludes all of my variegated plants. Even though I know variegation is not good for a plant, Sam will continue to love them. I would absolutely love to hear which one was your favorite from today, or if you've got a variegated plant that you really and truly love. Thank you so, so much for hanging out in the greenhouse with me. Let's have a chat down below, and I will see you guys in my next week's video. Bye. Mwah!